So this is really, really fun video because we've been really wanting to review these. And Entertainment Earth was nice enough to send us these to review for you guys. And once again, we are so excited because we're huge Munsters fans.
We are. I love the Munsters. They're on Netflix if you want to check it out. And the show is just, it's so innocently funny. I love
that. It's horror, but done in a comedic way.
Yes.
And it's great. Wonderful. And you guys, if you haven't seen it, if you're too young to really know what it was, I mean, we are too. But
yeah.
Fact of the matter is, we were able to watch it later down the road.
Mm-hmm.
And I'm telling you guys, just please watch it. Just watch a couple episodes. You're really going to love it. Halloween's coming up, so it's a perfect time to. Up first, we have Herman Munster, the Frankenstein of the family. Herman, as far as sculpt on this guy, I do not think he looks like Herman Munster.
Well, I think it's more of a simpler version of Herman Munster because they wanted to keep the pop form of his head. But I think he does because of that heavy brow.
Yeah, I don't know. To me, this doesn't represent Herman Munster very well.
Maybe his head should have been a couple inches taller.
Yeah, but I do like how his boots are taller, because if you watch the show, you'll know that he has to wear gigantic boots, and that's to make him look taller in real life. Now keep in mind, this is an old television show. It was done in black and white, and then later a movie done in color. But it was just really the way they filmed it was really fun, and you could tell like things when they're fake and real and all that stuff. It was just really fun, and that was, you know, part of that was the boots, where he had really tall boots to make him look like a Frankenstein. But other than that, I think the detail in this is really, really well done. He's got his kind of stitches on his forehead and his scar on it, and his straight face, which he had a straight face as well. And then most importantly, bolts in the neck, and that's really important.
Up next, we have Grandpa Munster, and I freaking love this pop. The hair, the little wisps of the hair, and his cape. He just looks so good, and look, he has his medallion on his chest.
So he's the funnest actor character inside the television show. He lives like in the basement, but his basement's like a lab. You know, the kind of the prototypical, not necessarily grandpa, but maybe.
Yeah, I was gonna say, maybe.
not even the prototypical, like, Dracula either. Like, I don't know how you explain it, but he's pretty awesome in the show. He's funny, he's the funny guy. He blows things up, he's, you know, kind of crazy. And one of the best characters, and they nailed it on the pop. I think that they did a fantastic job.
They really did, and he has like a little chin that comes down too. He looks excellent.
He does. I'm a huge fan of that. I when I saw that Grandpa Munster was gonna be in the line, that excited me so much. Up next, we have Eddie Munster, the youngin, and he even has his Wolfman plushie or whatever.
Oh my gosh, it's such a cute little thing. I love that he has it in his hands. He's just like carrying it around. And the actor who played Eddie Munster, I think he recently appeared on Comic Book Man or something from his costume or something.
Yeah, it was on Comic Book Man. He still had one. I think he's the only one living now. It is an old show. Eddie Munster was the werewolf. He was the young kid, but he turned into a werewolf at times. And that's what made him fun. So as far as a pop goes, you know, it's fun. You know, there's nothing spectacular about it, but I love how they included his Wolfman.
I love how small he is, too, so you can understand that he is a child compared to the
Herman,
adults.
Or Herman is really big.
Yeah. Last but not least in the Munsters line, we have Lily Munster, and she's really beautiful. She has that gray wisp of hair, too, and she's just standing there, like, in that all-knowing pose.
It is a great pose. They really nailed the pose on this one.
She's beautiful. Her makeup is like this nice blue, and she has like blue shading, like contouring on her face, which is a great, great detail to that. And she has a really beautiful gold necklace on.
Yeah, they nail it. So if you're a Munsters fan, if you're a Halloween fan, if you're a horror fan, there's no way you can't like this line. I think it's kind of impossible because the Munsters are so American, you know, they're so...
They really are.
You know, that's just something, when you think about just liking things that are horror.
And old TV shows.
And old TV shows, black and white. It's the Munsters. The Munsters all over it. But we do need to talk about one thing that's missing in the Munsters line.
Yeah.
More than characters, because there are some more characters that need to be involved. But the most important thing, the Munsters Mobile.
What?
We gotta have that pop ride.
That pop ride would be absolutely wonderful. It's such a cool car anyways, and just to see what they could do with that as a pop ride, I'm so excited for that. I want them to make it.
Very excited. So we think these pops are so awesome, we're gonna give them away.
Now, in order for you to win these pops, you have to do a few things to win. One, you have to be a subscriber. Two, like this video. And three, we're going to put this up on our Facebook, which is Funko Pop Hunters, our Twitter, which is Funko Pop Hunters, and our Instagram accounts, both of them, which is Funko Pop Hunters.
That's the one I run.
And then Nerd Therapy Official, which is the one I run.
And that's Nerd_Therapy_Official.
Right. And we will post a picture of these pops on there, what you have to do is just find that picture on one of the four things.
Yep.
Comment on it saying, I love the Munsters. I want to win the Munsters.
Whoa.
Something. And we will pick a person at random and let you know who the winner is. We will announce the winner on the format of who wins. So if it's an Instagram winner under the one that I run, the Nerd Therapy Official, we will announce it on there. If it is a winner under Facebook, we'll announce it under Funko Pop Hunters and so on and so forth.
So obviously the more chance, you get more chances if you go to all of them.
Go to all four and enter.
But if you only do one or two, we will contact you
right.
If you win, so don't worry about that. So once again, thanks Entertainment Earth for sending this out. Thank you, Bethany.
Thank you, Bethany.
And we will see you guys next time.
Thanks.
Bye.